Tractate Sanhedrin, page 35. We start with page 34b, three lines from the bottom of the page. Dinei nefashot danim bayom. So we learn in the Mishnah that when it's come to a capital or capital punishment, the court have a session during the day, but they have to complete it, since it's not a mandatory law, it's a capital law, they need to complete it during the daytime. Whereas the source, Menah Nemilei, Amar Rav Shimi Bar Chiya Amar Kra. Here the Torah speaks about those who worship idol of Peor in the book of Bamidbar, chapter 25. Vehoka otam laHashem neged haShamesh. They said that pasuk said they hang hoka them unto the Lord facing the sun, which means the capital cases judged in the face of the sun, which obviously it means during the day. So we derive from that when it's come to dinei nefashot, you have to do all these capital punishment in the daytime. Hamiri explains, because use the term neged haShemesh, across the sun. So it means that in order to avoid delay in uidin, you have to do it during the day. The Torat Chaim, the Shach, bring it. He says from the early part of the pasuk that said, "Kach et Rashi Ha'am," takes the Sanhedrin, the leader of the people, which means the Sanhedrin need to do both diyun, the discussion, as well as bitzua, meaning the physical execution. Vehoka, Amar Rav Chisda, minayin lehoka'a shehi tliya. Rav Chisda said, how do you know, from where you derive, that when it's come to hoka meaning hanging, dichtiv, here is in the book of Shmuel, the second book of Shmuel, chapter 21, the story of King David that accepted the conversion of the Gibeonites, and it turns that they claim that the King Saul killed some of their ancestors for no reason. King David asked the Almighty, and he get an answer of yes, meaning that they are right, and they ask to pay back to the grandson of King Saul, which later you see that King David said that's not a Jewish behavior. But anyway, the text itself said, "Dichtiv v'hoka'anum," we shall hang the children of King Saul, la'ashem begivat Shaul bechir Hashem. So therefore, since the derivative from the text applies to hanging, so you derive from that v'hoka'anum. It's hanging. So you derive from that v'hoka here applies to a capital punishment. Page 35. Uchtiv v'tikach ritzpa v'taya et asak v'tatehu la elatzu. Here in the book of Shmuel, the second one, chapter 21, the text speak about the King Solomon concubine, and she took, her name is Ritzpah, the daughter of Ayah. She took a sackcloth and spread it for her upon the rock from the beginning of the harvest until the water was poured upon them from the heaven. So you derive from that the pasuk speak about the bodies of children of King Saul. So that body remained exposed outdoor. Presumably, they were hung. Rashi here said, he bring something from Tractate Yevamot, page 79, and he said, the end, halalu bnei melachim hem upashtu yadam begerim gurim, meaning to sanctify the name of God, to show that God helped those in need. Obviously, in that case, was the convert, that even from the sons of king, they are hung longer than the regular period of time. K'tiv, that's basically the Maharshal said that it's a new sugiya. Vayomer Hashem el Moshe kach et kol Rashi Ha'am. They said in that text in Bamidbar 25 that God said to Moshe Rabbeinu, take all the head of the people. So it means and ve'okar tam la Hashem neged Hashem shemesh. So, if people worship idol, why you ask, why you expect the chiefs to pay? Did they need to pay for the mistake? So the Meiri said that they should basically express strongly their opposition, but the general concept is that they get paid by heaven, the heaven punishment. Why they put a punishment of hanging them? אמר רבוד אמר רב אמר לו הקדוש ברוך למשה חילק חלק להם בתי דינים. God said to Moses, I apportion courts for the chiefs of the tribe, and each court will judge and punish the transgressor of the tribes. So basically it's more to show the people that there is a no favoritism, but obviously the 23 judges that reside in the rabbinic court that involve with punishment, which caused Sanhedrin Ektana, that's the derivative from the Psukim. The Ramban said, and others, that they hung all those people who did it. Mai tama ilei ma mishum shen dalim shnayim biyom echad. You do not have a judgment against two people when it's come to capital punishment in one day. That's what we're going to study on page 45. Ve'amar Rav Chisda, lo shanu ela b'shtei mitot. All of that applies to two different capital punishment. But aval b'mita achad danim. But the court does judge multiple cases of one type of death, which is one transgressor, on the same day. So Rabbeinu Yonah here asks a question. People have a different violation, a different punishment, and different actions. So why you said here that it applies to all, the mitah achat? So there's a book called Sanhedrin Ktana. Sanhedrin Ktana said that yes, as far as the violation was violation, but he said, since the pasuk said vayishtachavu, he says kulam ishtachavu, which means that it's a mechane mishutaf lekulam, it's a mechanism between all of them. They did the same violation. That's from the book Sanhedrin Ktana. Ela kedei sheshuv acharon af miYisrael, in order to fulfill the charon af, meaning to take the anger of God, turn away from Israel, the fierce anger of God remain until those who engage in idol worship were punished. So therefore it was necessary to try them in kind of haste. The Yad Rama said, because the Pasuk tells us, ubi'arta hara mikirbecha, should expunge the evil from your midst. So that's part of Charon Af Yored Be'am Israel, that the anger, the roughness assuage, move away from the nation when is it a punishment right away. Dinei Mamonot Gomrim B'Bayom. We said when it's come to monetary disputation, we finish that day, regardless if it's a merit or exemption, versus the Dinei Nefashot, capital law, you have to wait for the following day when it's a person turned to be liable. How do you derive it for the capital law? Amar Rabbi Chanina, Amar Kra, we said in Isaiah chapter 1, verse 21, Melaati mishpat tzedek yalin ba ve'ata meratzchim. This is what we said in Haftarah of Chazon Yeshayahu. The prophet Isaiah said that the Pasuk speaks about the first temple. He said, she, meaning that it's a euphemism to, that used for the temple, she that was full of justice, righteousness, large in hair, but now murderers. So that's associated with lodging or waiting overnight with justice. So, מהחה ורב אמר מהחה אשרו חמוץ אשרו דיין שמחמץ את דינו. Praise אשרו the judge that verdict before he pronounces it. ואידך אשרו חמוץ, so the Yad Rama said חמוץ ולא חומץ. So here, Yad Ramas speaks about different pronunciation, which is victim, relieve the robbery victim, but not the robber, as do the wicked judges, which unfortunately they pay attention to those who bribe them. So the Gemara said, "Ve'idach haim le'eti mishpat mai avid lei." So what is the derivative from the she was full of justice, righteousness larger there, but now murders? כדי רבי לזר אמר רבי יצחק, דמר רבי לזר אמר רבי יצחק, כל תענית שמלינים בו את הצדקה, כאילו שופך דמים. Said every first day on which the distribution of charity is left overnight, it's considering like a spill of blood for the poor people, because they have fasted the day and the expectation that they will receive charity before the day was over in order to purchase food, so they can break the fast properly. שנאמר מלאיתי משפט צדק, ואני מילה בריפתא וחמרי, all of that applies bread and date, which is food that's ready to be consumed immediately. אבל בזוזי חיטי וסערי, but when it comes to money, wheat and barley, you don't have an issue. Late lanban. לפיכך אין דנים מיתמה. So therefore, the court does not judge the cases of capital law on certain days, neither on Shabbat eve or the eve of festival. What's the reason? משום דלא אפשר יחל העבד, because it's not possible, so what do you... לילדיין הם מלא שבתא ולגמיר לדיני בעלי שבתא דין מחזותם לחובה. If you do it in the eve of Shabbat, and you put the verdict on Shabbat eve, perhaps we should see a reason to find the accused liable, and in this situation the court is required to perform suspension of the trial until the following day. הוא בא למעבד על ענת דין, לדיינה במעלי שבתא ולגמיר בשבתא ולגתה בשבתא, אין רציחה דוחה את השבת. The kill does not override the law of Shabbat, so it cannot be done as a murder. וליקטלי לאורתא, so we should kill him at night, which is after the conclusion of Shabbat, מוצאי שבת. So the Torah said נגד השמש בעינן, you have to do it facing the sun, which is the meaning it's you have to do it during the time. וליגמר לידנה בשבתא וליגנה בחד בשבתא. We should do it on the eve of Shabbat and conclude the verdict on Shabbat and kill him on Sunday. So they said, נמצא את המענה דינו. You basically delay the verdict. נדאי נמלא שבתא ונגמר בחד בשבתא, מין שוטה מהיו. So if you do it on Sunday, so you basically, the judge will forget the reasons for the position in the interim. אבל גם שני סופרי הדינים עומדים לפניהם, even the two סופרי הדינים, the two scribes sit the front of them, וכותבים דברי המזכים ודברי המחייבים, they find both statement, the one who exempt and one who make them liable, נהיד בפומה כתבין, which means that the mouth of the judge, which is their tentative verdict, לקה דאין שאין שלהי כך לא אפשר, the heart of people are forgetful, and they will forget the reason. So therefore, it's not possible to begin deliberations in cases of dinei nefashot of capital law on Shabbat Eve or festival Eve. Amar l'Reish Lakish l'Rabbi Yochanan v'tei k'vurat met mitzvah docha et Shabbat mikal v'chomer. So since we talk about d'chiyat Shabbat, so Reish Lakish asked to Rabbi Yochanan, how about the burial of a corpse when it's nobody else take care of that? It's a met mitzvah. So that should override Shabbat by means so that you can have kal vachomer. Uma avodah shedocha Shabbat kvorat met mitzvah docha otah mi v'la'achoto. Since that the service of the temple override Shabbat, so here when it's come to burial of met mitzvah override it, based on interpretation, the Torah said in the book of Numbers chapter 6, v'la'achoto and his sister. So it means that that it should be like that. So the Gemara left it pause for a second, the Tanya. So basically, just to share with you the Rambam, Hilchot Bet HaMikdash chapter 4, sacrificial rite that have fixed time to be performed over override Shabbat. For this reason, the priests offer the daily offerings and additional offering, as well as the additional offering of festival, when they occurred on Shabbat. The Kohanim performs all the attendance of this offering, even on Shabbat. The Torah said in the book of Numbers chapter 6, when it's come to have the tum'ah, the contamination in ritual bath, it's applied to what? Father, mother, brother, sister. So what must the verse state for all these relatives? הרי שהולך לשחול פתחו ולאמור לדנו, if someone was a Nazirite, and he was going to slaughter his Paschal offering, or to have the Brit Milah, the circumcision of his son. 35b, ושמע שמת לא מת. So here is a situation that when he heard that one is a relative passed away, יכול יתמע. So maybe he can be contaminated. The same way as the Torah said about regular Kohen Ediot in the book of Vayikra in Leviticus chapter 21. So that that's the derivative of the sages that he allowed to do it. That's part of the La'achoto Betula La'itama to his sister. So Yachol Itame Amart Lo itama. So we said that he shall not make himself impure. Meaning when you have a relative that passed away, will not override the certificate of mitzvah from the Torah. So yachol, kishem shelo metame l'achoto, kach lo metame l'emet mitzvah. So you may say the same words that he not contaminated to his sister, same words not applied to met mitzvah. Talmud lomar v'la'achoto, l'achoto uno metame. אבל מתמה למת מצווה. So that's the derivative from the אחותו. So it means that a person needs to bury a met mitzvah, even by doing so he cannot bring his paschal lamb. Why? Because that's the mitzvah of burial, met mitzvah, override avodat הקורבנות, the law of the offering. So in general, the whole concept of melacha she'ena tzricha legufa in Shabbat. So it's a story that the late Reb Moshe Feinstein, Zecher Tzadik Lebracha, speaks about his father, who was a well-known rabbi in Russia. And in those days, it was a magifa, it was a tremendous plague. So the government put a rule that if people passed away from those plagues, they need to be buried immediately. Even if it was Shabbat. So the Chevra Kadisha have an issue here because they said, yes, it is true that it's Pikuach Nefesh Dochei Shabbat, but they said our job is to bury things that are allowed. But here, so Moshe Feinstein brings a raya from the Sota. Why? Because they said about Sota that the Kohen need to turn the woman's garments. And obviously no one wants to do that. So they made the lottery, they make a goral. And in that goral, they put also Kohen Gadol. So it the same here, they all need to participate. In general, Rabbi Akiva Iger said that anything that is in Kvod HaMet, it's mitzvah. Anyway, so Shabbat, שנתחל מפני עבודה, אינו דין שתחל גבורת מת מצווה ודוחה אותה, אמר לי רציחה תוכיח, שדוחה את העבודה ואינה דוחה את השבת. So רציחה גופה תדחה את השבת. You can say that the murder itself should override Shabbat. Why? Because you have this קל וחומר. מקל וחומר, מה העבודה שדוחה את השבת רציחה דוחה אותה? שנאמר מי מזבחית יקחנו למות. שבת שנדחה מפני עבודה אינו דין שרציחה דוחה אותה. אמר רבא כבר פסקה תנא דברבי ישמעאל, לתנא דברבי ישמעאל לא תברור יש מה תלמוד לומר. So the Gemara said, "What Talmud lomar? Il Rabbi Yosi lav yatzat. Il Rabbi Natan lechalek yatzat. Kedetanya avara lav yatzat. Kindling or fire was singled out to teach that one who lights on Shabbat violates the ordinary prohibition. Diver Rabbi Yosi, Rabbi Natan lomer lechalek yatzat. So the Chavot Yair in Siman Kuf Lamed Bet." Chapter 132, he brings the whole idea here of Isi ben Yehuda. Because Isi ben Yehuda said that this is one of the 39 melachot, that you don't, one of the 39 lo chayavim mita. one of them. So he said, may you say here from the word of Rabbi Yossi, Avaral Lav Yatzat. But he said he cannot do it. The Chavot Yair said that Isur Kibui, the extinguishing Letzorech Avara, if you tell me that Avaral Lav Yatzat, so it means that Kibui lo chayev mita. So Isi hold only one thing. And Rabbi Yudah, Rabbi Yossi here, basically they say Avara Lav Yatzat, so the Avara, there are two separate things. Ela amar Rav Hatana Moshavot Kashel, ma Moshavot ma Talmud lomar Mikdei Shabbat Chovad Hagufi. Chovad Haguf noeged ben baretz ben bechutz laaretz Moshavot dechatav Rachmana lama li. So why the Torah said habitations? So Mishum Rabbi Shmuel amar Talmid echad lefi shenemar ki ebed echad. כי באיש, לפי שנאמר, כי באיש חטא משפט מוות ואומת, שומע אני במלאכות בן בשבת. Anyway, ומה אני מקיים מחלל אלמות, יאמר בשער מלאכות חוץ ממיתת בדין, או אינו אלא אפילו ממיתת בדין, ומה אני מקיים ואומת בחול, אבל לא בשבת, או אינו אלא אפילו בשבת. תמוד לומר לו, תבררו יש בכל מושבותיכם, ולאלן אומר, והיו לכם לחוקת משפט לדורותיכם בכל מושבותיכם, מה מושבות אמורות לאלן בדין, אב מושבות אמורן כאן בדין, אמר רחמן לו, תבררו יש בכל מושבותיכם. So you see here that the rabbinic court does not administer capital punishment on Shabbat. אומר רבי, אחי אשתה. אומר רבי, אשתה, דאמרת. אומר רבי, אשתה, דאמרת. אין רציחה דוחה את השבת, אין רציחה דוחה את העבודה, מקל וחומר. ומה שבת שנתחיל מפני העבודה, אין רציחה דוחה אותה. עבודה שהיא דוחה את השבת, נועדים שלא תהיה רציחה דוחה אותה. אלא דחתה, מי מזבחית יקחנו למות, האילו קורבן יחיד ולא דחי שבת. So that's only the individual. It's not override שבת. אמרה ביחד לא תהיה רכי צריכה דוחה, קורבן יחיד מקל וחומר. Page 36. מה יום טוב שנדחה מפני קורבן יחיד אינו רציחה דוחה אותו, קורבן יחיד שהוא דוחה את יום טוב אינו דין שלא תהיה רציחה דוחה אותו. הניחא למאן דאמר אין נדרים ונדבות קרבים ביום טוב, למאן דאמר אין נדרים ונדבות קרבים ביום טוב, מה יקרא למאמר? So he said, אלא מראה אבל לא מבעיה למאן דאמר אין נדרים ונדבות קרבים ביום טוב, דעה לא מתקיים מי מזבחי כלל. אלא אפילו מה דאמר נדרים ונדבות אין קרבים ביום טוב אקטיב מי מזבחי, מזבחי המיוחד לי, מעניינו תמיד, במרחמנה, מי מזבחי דיקחנו למות.